One of the things that's really limited about ConvertKit, which otherwise is a great email marketing software, is their ability to run split tests. So say you have a list of 10,000 people, you want to send out one version of an email to 5,000, one version of an email to another 5,000, you can't do that in ConvertKit. Well, I've actually worked out how to do it, and I wanted to share with you how to run a split test email campaign in ConvertKit. Now, this isn't super easy. There are some steps to do and some manual work, but you can make it happen. So here are the steps for those of you who don't want to go through the full tutorial. First thing you need to do is you need to export your list into an Excel document. So you get your entire list, export it into an Excel document. The next thing you need to do is divide it randomly. And so there is a random function inside Excel. So you do that, divide it randomly, and you can then segment your list into two separate parts or pull out portions of your list. Once you've done that, you then need to import that list, give them their own separate tags. You then create two email broadcasts and only send it to people based on those tags. And lastly, you track it. So that's exactly what we're going to go through, and I'll show you how to do it. So just so you know, if you're not a member of ConvertKit yet, but you want to become one, I do have an affiliate link which helps fund this channel. Go to pelt.co/CK for ConvertKit, and I really appreciate that. So the first step is to export your list. So I find the easiest way to do this is to create a segment. So if we go ahead and click create a segment, we'll give it a name. I'm just going to call it example list because it's for this example. So you can add a whole bunch of different filters. You can match any, all, none. So you can exclude things and stuff like that. Let's say I want everyone that has the tag OP general. So I'm going to add that. And I'm gonna add filter, so I don't want any of my customers to be in this. So I'm just kind of showing you a more complicated example. So if I go to customers, there should be OPC customer here. And so we'll go ahead and create that, add filter, and we can see that this has gone down by about 300 people. We'll then go ahead and click save. That will then create our segment, which just makes it easier to export, and this segment's constantly being updated. So go ahead, click on the segment. We've got an example list there. Let's go ahead and highlight everyone. So select all of these subscribers. We're then going to go ahead and export it. So bulk actions, we'll go to export. And so it says success, your export is processing. So they're gonna send me out an email with that export in there. So we just gotta wait for that email to come through. Okay, great, that export file is ready. I can go ahead and download that file. Now I'm going to go ahead and open this file in Excel. So currently the Excel document looks like this, and I've hidden the email addresses just for this video, but usually that would show email addresses. So we need to create another column. Let's go ahead and call this random, and we need to put a formula in here that's going to create random numbers. So if we go equals rand and then just do brackets like that with nothing inside it, that's going to now generate a random number. I'm going to go ahead and copy this. I'm going to click on number 3. I'm going to scroll all the way down to number 19,000. Hold shift and click down to there. So I've got all of those. We'll go and paste it in. And this is now going to create random numbers for everything. Now, let's go ahead and we will sort this. So let's add a filter in here. And from random, we can go ahead and click ascending, descending, it doesn't matter. But basically, that's now going to be random. So we can see all the sign-up dates are very random there between 2015 and 16. And so now we can begin dividing this list up into two different parts. So all we're gonna need is the first name and email address. Now, for the example that I had, I wanted to email 1,000 people out of my list of 20,000. You might wanna send 50% somewhere, 50% somewhere else. So let's just see how many emails do we have. We've got 19,353. It's actually 19,352 because we got that first row for the headers. So half of that is 9,676. So let's go ahead and find 9,676, which is here. And basically what I'm going to do is highlight those two. I'm going to go all the way up to the top. I'm going to click shift, and I'm going to go ahead and let's go ahead and copy those. I'll open up a new sheet. And I'll put first name, email, and then I'll go ahead and paste that in. So we've got those in there. I can now go ahead and delete all of these from this one. So hold on, let's go ahead and we'll highlight that one, go up to the top, highlight number two, and delete. Okay, so they should now be deleted. If I scroll down, yeah, we can see that we've only got 9,677 in this list. And in this list, if we scroll down, we should have a similar amount, 9,676. So slightly uneven by a couple of people, but I'm not too worried about that. So let's go ahead and export this as a CSV file. So I'm just going to save it as CSV. I'm going to call it list one and go ahead and click save. So I save the first tab as list one. I then go to the second tab and save that as list two. So I've now got two CSV files. So I'll save this tab as list one and I'll save the original tab as list two. So I've now got two CSV files. So once I've exported and divided them randomly, we're then going to import and tag these. So in order to tag them, we first need to create a tag. So let's just create a tag and I'll call it list one. All right, and we can then also create another tag and we'll call that one list two. All right, so you can obviously name these anything you want. As I said, this wasn't a simple thing to do, but it can be done if you need to do it. So the next thing is to import subscribers. So let's go ahead and click on that. Now we want to add these subscribers to list one. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to pull in list one here. And so first name and email, and we'll go ahead and click import subscribers. So that will now go ahead and import our subscribers, and we can see list one now has 9,674 subscribers. You would repeat that same process for list two, and that's how we import and tag people. So you've got two separate lists, they need to have two separate tags because that's important when we send out two email broadcasts. So let's go ahead and send out a broadcast, click on broadcast, click on new broadcast, and then what we want to do is we want to select it to match. Okay, let's see. We want people subscribed to the tag and we want list one. Okay, so we'll update that filter. For good measure, I would also make sure that they're not on list two, just so they're not getting two emails because that is possible. So let's say make sure that they're not subscribed to tag list two. Now I haven't imported list two yet, so it won't make any difference, but that's kind of just covering my bases in case I've made a mistake. We then go through and we create our broadcast and then, you know, we put in the email subject, email content, create it, and we can save it as a draft or we can send it out. We would then repeat the process, but for list two. So we'd want them to be tagged for list two and not for list one. And we would make the changes that we wanted to make in our email. Ideally, you would send them both out about the same time to get a good result. Or if you're split testing the time you send it out, then obviously you can stagger those times. So you need to send out two individual email broadcasts. And then the last step is to track it. And tracking in ConvertKit isn't the best tracking in the world. However, you can get basic tracking. So you can see, like, let's see, I've just sent out this email recently. We can see open rate and click-through rate. So this email I sent out about 20 minutes ago. So we can see that. And ideally, you know, you'd send out two of them and you'd have two next to each other. So you can see a difference in open rate, see a difference in click-through rate, see a difference in unsubscribers, or if you're tracking conversions into things, then you could send them to different landing pages and track the conversions based off that. So basically, that's how to run a split test email campaign in ConvertKit. You need to export your entire list, divide your list randomly using that rand feature inside Excel. You need to import and tag two separate CSV files and give them separate tags. You then send out two email broadcasts based on those tags, and you can then track it after that. So obviously with these two email broadcasts here, that's where you're split testing things and making them different in some way. And that is how to run a split test email marketing campaign inside ConvertKit. It is not easy. Hopefully soon ConvertKit will add this feature, as I know that a lot of people have requested this. But at the moment, if you're desperate to do it and you don't want to move away from ConvertKit, which is the situation I was in, this is a way to run a split test if you need to do it every once in a while. I hope that this has been helpful to you. Again, I do highly recommend ConvertKit. I absolutely love it, even though it lacks this split testing feature, because it's just so user-friendly. It looks great. It's easy to use and segment people and send out emails based on the actions people have taken. It's really good. If you haven't signed up yet and you want to, I do appreciate if you go through my affiliate link. We're at no extra cost to yourself. Just go to pelt.co/CK if that's something you're interested in. That's it from me, guys. Go out there and work on your internet business, and I hope that you achieve great success.